listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. Now the largest new media platform on the web and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Dean
Johnson.
The AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California, presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com, and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies, this is AfterBuzz TV's The Challenge After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's The Challenge After Show.
Yo, what up, AfterBuzzers? Bing is for doing, and we are doing another AfterBuzz TV After Show here for The Challenge, MTV's Battle of the Seasons. Season 23, episode 4. Caught me off guard. I was tweeting, so mind me with that. We are joined in studio with, you heard her lovely little laugh, the one, the only, Roxy Striar.
Hello.
And joining us, she decided she was going to join us on camera because last time she was in studio, she just wanted to sit back, relax, check out what AfterBuzz was about.
I wanted to check it out.
Yeah. But now she's here and she's ready. She's ready for it. We have the one, the only, Miss Jonna.
Yeah.
You might recognize her from The Challenge, also Real World Cancun. All right, girls, ready?
Okay, I'm ready. It's like a big breath moment. Now let's go. Okay.
Well, we're going to wait for the steamer to get online. I believe we're going to have Zach call in as well.
Yeah.
So we can pick both your brains. But let's talk about the first topic that I want to get into. And we had some love going on here on the show. But before we get into the love, let's talk about the hate.
Okay.
There's
only one person you could be talking about, the instigator, the one, the only Knight.
Knight.
Mm.
What do we think of Knight's actions? Strategic or just kind of bullying or?
I really like him and then I hate his guts. And I can't tell exactly how to feel about him. So we need somebody who's met him and knows him more personally to speak on the matter.
But I think he really tries to get into people's heads.
And was this the first time that on the show he started getting into people's heads or?
I think he always just jokes around with everyone and tries to mess with them, so.
It's just like, how are you going to take this girl? It seemed like there was nothing wrong with Nany and that they didn't have any beef. I mean, unless we just didn't see it on the show, he just decided to pick Nany, went into her room, took her laundry, and put it in the pool. There was no fight before that, and he said that she's really mentally weak,
yep.
So he was trying to break her down.
Which is very true, if you ever have watched her season.
Right, which is true, but I don't really understand. I'm so a kill them with kindness kind of person than a break them down until they're too weak to move kind of person.
I don't know. You'll have to ask Zach, but Zach and Knight had this whole, like, bromance thing going on, and I think ever since, like, Nany and Zach had it in for each other, that Knight was just, like,
did they know each other before the show?
I don't think so.
So it was just, like, alliance.
Well, no, it's like when Nany was arguing with Zach, like Knight stepped in a little bit, and ever since then they were just like, oh, we don't like Nany, so they kind of like formed a little thing against her. And
Nani's got some haters out there.
Yeah, and I mean, obviously, it did kind of come out of nowhere.
Or at least for us, as I'm saying, as audience members, we're sitting there like, what the hell just happened?
So did it work? Do we think that this is a strategic, or do we think it also kind of paints a larger target on their back? I mean, not really Zach's back, because, I mean, it never really went back to him, but does that...
I don't know. Nany walked into the house, and she had so many friends, and that's why she was originally part of our alliance. But when she got there, I don't think she quite understood the challenge setting and how everything would be, and she kind of, like, freaked out and broke down.
Freaked out like she took things personal from people? Or
I think she took things way too personally.
See, I thought she dealt with the whole pool situation really well.
She did.
Well, thanks to Dustin, who I think really helped, and Big Easy, who were sitting there, and they helped. If somebody completely unwarranted took my stuff and threw it in the pool, are you I would have been like, what the hell's wrong with
you? Like the original, the laundry one.
Hell to the no!
Right, mm-hmm. The laundry one, that's when I would have been like, oh, hell to the no. But then when you actually go and get my suitcase, and throw it in? Because you don't know. I mean, what if I and put my cell phone or something in there? Like,
and it is a better play.
This isn't Bad Girls Club. Like,
it is a better play for Nany to be like, do what you want to me. I'm not budging. I'm not breaking down. Strategically, it's a better move. But at the same time, this is a real person with real emotions, and I would freak the hell out. I mean, it's just clothes, but everything
it's
she
your
has.
Belongings.
Yeah, it's your stuff. Like, it's just rude. I don't understand why somebody would disrespect somebody. That's not a prank.
And
that's hurting somebody.
I mean, and I think I understand what he's saying, like trying to break somebody down. I just think that was almost, that prank wasn't strong enough to really affect her.
Yeah.
I think it was kind of weak.
She handled it well.
And she definitely handled it well. But I think it was so weak that now you just pissed her off. And now she can come back with a vengeance. I mean, if you're going to go for the kill, like, go hard or go home. I mean, that's what the challenge basically comes down to.
I think that our alliance kind of knew that Vegas was kind of, like, on the fence as it was. So Knight
was
just, like,
whatever. Why was Vegas always kind of half in, half out?
I don't know, you know. I think that they were a part of our alliance from the very beginning, and we just didn't know if we knew that Team Cancun, Team San Diego, no matter what, like, everything would be fine. But Vegas, we were, like, on the fence. We were, like, we don't know if they're going to, like, eventually win a game down the road and then, like, screw one of us over, you know.
So same way you guys felt about St. Thomas.
Yeah.
But Cancun was more... I mean, Vegas was more in the alliance.
They were originally in
St. Thomas.
In St. Thomas, it was just Marie and Rob that were a part of the alliance originally. And the reason why was because, you know, Marie and Frank were really good friends. And at the very beginning, they were like, we hate Trey and Laura. We don't want them to be on our team. Like,
who said that? Marie and Rob?
Yeah, Marie and Rob. They're like, do whatever you can to save us. And when it's St. Thomas's time to go in, like, we'll go in, and then you guys send in the other two.
Okay.
Well, before we send in the other two, we actually are going to send in the one. We have Zach on the line with us. What's up, Zach?
What the fuck is up?
Well, why don't you tell us? Because, I mean, we haven't gotten you on AfterBuzz, so, I mean, here we are. We're watching you. I know you're watching yourself. I can imagine the Twitter comments that you get coming at you. I'm sure a lot of positive, and I'm sure there's some negative ones out there. What are you making out of this season from what you've seen so far?
Season? Well, let me begin, first of all, by saying I'm a closet fan of the show. I watch it. I like to watch you guys on YouTube. And the reason why I don't call in or come on the show is because I actually want to strangle the lady douches that are on the show.
It's
they
fair
just,
enough.
They're so tough on me. And for never being on a reality TV show, they're really hard on me. And it sort of really pissed me off. But I've learned to forget. I've learned to forgive and forget.
I've been calling a lady douche before.
Credit this season.
It's, I mean, you know, all of us, we're all hard on all you guys. It's what we do. But, I mean, watching this season that you're seeing, I mean, from what we knew, you and Zach hated each other. Then we come on to the Battle of the Seasons, and you guys...
Him and Frank, you mean?
Him and Frank. Who did I say?
Like, him and Zach, which would be like a little schizo. So,
you hated yourself. No. You know, you and Zach, I mean, oh, look at me. All right, you and I'm sick, so I'm
Frank
like on
Zach.
Cold medications
Frank
and everything.
Zach.
Frank and Zach, you guys didn't like each other in San Diego. Where did the alliance, how did you guys, you know, kind of squash all the beef and...
Okay, well, let's see. What happened was, on San Diego, Frank was going through a huge growth period in his life, like with the just coming out right before the show and the whole bi, gay, you know, urophiliac, whatever the hell he, you know, goes into. He, like, was going through a huge thing, and I think there was a lot of insecurities there where there was also a lot of insecurities with me, too, being on television from, you know, Podunk, Michigan. And there's just one thing led to another, just two alpha males butting heads. Plus, I had vagina goggles on with, you know, Ashley.
Right.
So it just was a whole bad situation for two guys to go through a huge growing experience while being on camera and both wanting to kind of, you know, look like the alpha male and not look bad at the same time. So it was just a huge clashing of heads. But I learned what happened was Ashley and I broke up, and it was like one night I just, like, texted Frank, and I was like, texted him, and then, like, he ended up calling me, and we just kind of, like, squashed it, and, like, I think we were both wasted, and it was, like, a drunken conversation, and the next day we actually texted each other, like, hey, Eric, like, do you remember last night? Like, yeah, we're cool. So then, like, from there, like, we started getting the call for the challenge, and we knew we were probably going to have to work together, so it just kind of made sense to try to squash it, you know?
I mean, not only did it make sense, but it was worked out very well for you guys, because it seems like you guys are just going in there running shit. And I'm not going to say intimidating people, because I don't think you guys are in each people's faces, but I think just the power of you two is intimidating. Now,
definitely.
You know, I want to talk
a lot
about
of sexual. That's a lot of sexual energy coming at you at once.
I mean,
I can only imagine. You know,
I mean, you're hitting both scenes here. You got the straight demographic and the gay. So, I mean, that is very powerful. So, in this challenge that we saw tonight, this whole situation with Knight, I know Janae was just telling us earlier that you and Knight were kind of had like a little alliance against Nany.
They want to know why Knight out of nowhere, like, threw Nany and shit in the pool.
Oh,
it wasn't out of nowhere, so explain.
Well, in all honesty, Nany she's pretty ratchet. Like, she's pretty hood and pretty disgusting.
That's amazing.
Like, she, like, went in there and kind of, like, just turned to this, like, I was actually cool with her, and you can ask Jonna, I was cool with her for the first, like, whatever, couple weeks or whatever, and then she just, like, once, like, things kind of got, like, where her team started to look like shit because they weren't, like, just kind of, like, falling, doing what they needed to do. Like, you had to throw Brooklyn in there. Why would you make any problems within people that have your back at that point? And when I kind of told her, like, I don't fucking trust you, I don't think, like, and Jonna was the same way, and so was everyone.
Zach,
she kind of started to get a little chip on her shoulder towards us. Then she said that she was never friends with any of the people that she was friends with. And she just was, like, being a pretty terrible person. So I don't know why one day I just decided to get squirrely. And, you know, Knight and I, actually, I was with Knight. I may or may not have helped throw her laundry in. Thank God they edited me out of that, because I love watching Knight get the heat when it was probably more of my idea. And I just kind of slipped under the radar.
Zach's like an instigator with Knight. He's like, I bet you won't do it.
And Knight always does it. He's like, I will.
Right, well, because Knight was probably trashed and like, oh, I'll do it.
Well, overall, you seem to have a very different, I mean, you're saying that I was a lady douche to you last season, but I think you were kind of a douche the last time you were on, but this time you seem to be a completely different person. Change of heart, or just the fact that you and Frank were cool, or you were cool with all your teammates. Like, what was the biggest change for you?
Or maybe the lady in your life is just not negative energy.
Oh.
Well, yeah, I mean, yeah, this lady, she's okay. No, I'm just kidding. She's great. She actually, her and I hit it off right away, and, like, it made it a lot easier to be there. Like, everyone, like, is asking me how I dealt with this crazy situation. Like, I just remember kind of just, like, having a blast. Like, I never wasn't having a great time. And if you really think about it, like, Frank always had my back, like, even, like, sometimes in San Diego, they don't, like, we both got a terrible edit in San Diego. Like, there were times where, like, he and I, like, got along great, and there was a lot of times where, like, we, you know, it just, like, they gave us both terrible edits, and, like,
I think you could see that. I think it just more towards
there was never,
end.
Like, they never showed a good moment for either of us. It seemed like it was always, like, me being a sarcastic douche and him being a lunatic, you know, so we never really got great edits. And it really just came down to, like, me. I just, like, grew up. Like, I went on that show thinking, you know, my shit didn't stink. Then I washed myself and had, like, death threats sent to my house. And I was like, you know what? Like, I am kind of a douche on this show. Like, I know that's not me all the time. I know I got a bad edit. But there's certain things about me that I can fix and I can work on. And I tried to. And, you know, you grow up a lot watching yourself. You know, it's kind of like, when you think back, like, when you say something or do something, and, like, you think back, and you're like, oh, man, I shouldn't have done that. Well, times that by about a million, it's like getting kicked in the nuts when you got to watch yourself be a douchebag, you know?
Yeah. Do you guys see more people rooting for you guys being together? Because, I mean, when,
like,
once you're...
Jack and I?
Yeah, you and Zach, do you guys think that more people are rooting for you? Because I'm not going to lie, here at AfterBuzz, like we talked about in the first... And actually, I want you to clear this up. We kind of did. But the first episode of the challenge, we were like, wait a minute, she just broke up with her boyfriend the first day?
It wasn't the first day.
Yeah, she got a horrible edit. That was like 2 weeks in. Like, we had already been hanging out. We hadn't even kissed when she broke up with her boyfriend. Like, we didn't kiss for like a long time. And that first kiss was forever into the show. Like, I was like trying to prolong it even more. But that, you know, that was nearly impossible. But you know what I'm saying? Like, it was a horrible edit. It made it look like she was, you know, a wiener-hungry whore. That's what it made it look like. And I even, like, commented on everyone. I was like, this is awkward to watch. Because this is not how it went down at all. It, like, literally
it's
made
not,
it look
like
I walked into the house with a cape and a pink Speedo, and she dumped her boyfriend. That's how it looked.
Right.
That's what happened. No,
Wiener-hungry whore. That is,
yeah.
And lady douches. No, go ahead. So go ahead, Nany. What's your side?
Well, sorry, what was the question?
What's your side? What happened? You walked in and
you broke up with your boyfriend.
Yeah, well, the thing is I don't want, I have a lot of integrity, and I didn't want to do things the wrong way, and I think the producers knew that I wasn't going to, like, continue things on with Zach until we got phone time, and I actually got to break up with the guy that I was dating back home. So it was, I don't know, it was a little bit dramatic.
How was it, Zach, going in? I mean, how early on did you know that who was going to be on your team?
Me?
Yeah.
They knew before.
Well, it was actually pretty early because we knew we were, besides St. Thomas, we were one of the newest seasons. So, like, they called all of us, and they called, like, everyone from our season except for one girl. And we knew that Priscilla was still in school. We knew Alex has, you know, Alex is, like, Alicia Keys' little sister or some bullshit, so she wasn't going to go. And we knew that it was between me and Frank, but we knew we only had two girls. And we knew that we were probably for sure to get cast because we, you know, no one had seen our team besides Nate or Priscilla. So we were, Frank and I pretty much, he called me and we were like, you know what, they're not going to cast Nate because who would you rather see, like, who's going to bring more drama and who's going to bring a better show? And it's going to, at this point, it's going to be Frank and I. So we kind of knew a whole bar forward before we even went into the game.
They knew about their
game. And it made it a lot easier to strategize and to kind of, like, talk about things. But as you'll see, like, the game throws you unexpected twists where sometimes it takes a lot more than just shaking hands and saying, hey, man, we're cool now. You know, you got to have more of a better friendship, a better foundation than just that. Because this game is crazy. Like, it gets in everyone's head, including mine at certain points.
Do you think that if you hadn't known you were going in with Frank, would you guys have never made up and just parted ways and been done with each other?
That's a good question.
No, because actually we made up before they even called us for the challenge. And literally, like I said, I was drunk at an appearance, and he was drunk too, because if I'm drinking, there's probably a 98% chance Frank's drinking.
Drunk. Yeah.
And it literally, I texted him, and all I texted him was like, hey, man, like, I'm really sorry. That's all I texted him, and then, like, he called me. And it was, like, a 10-minute wasted conversation. Like, we both fucked up. Like, because we're a lot alike. Like, we're strangely a lot alike.
Yeah, you can see that on the season.
They're in a ton of ways. So it just makes sense that, like, when we fight, the fights are nasty and just disgusting and dirty. And we both, like, you know, we both try to, like, crush the other person. But, like, when we get along, like, we get along very well.
Well, and you saw even when he bugged out, like, just the way you calmed him down, it seemed like that's how you would want to be calmed down in a situation that you were bugging. You just knew exactly what to do, who not to have around.
Very well.
But what about the drama? I mean, were you nervous to go on the show with Ashley?
Yeah.
You know what? No, I wasn't, because in all truthfulness, what had happened was she had broken up with me for whatever reason, you know, and for me, in the back of my head, it was like, okay, like, I kind of felt like since I got dumped, that I had the upper hand and that I could get away with a lot more, where I think she was walking on eggshells. And I wasn't nervous because, the only thing I was nervous about with Ashley was I didn't know if she could compete. I didn't know if she could do anything athletic because she'd never done anything athletic. And that's what I was more nervous about. I thought she was an absolute dud because I knew that she would be willing because Ashley's money hungry and she does enjoy a large check. I knew that she would be willing to listen to whatever Frank and I said, so I wasn't worried about that, and I wasn't worried about her political game. I was just more worried about her as an athlete.
Weren't you guys doing three-a-days when you were on The Real World? I feel like she was in the gym with you every second, or was she just kind of watching you lift weights?
Right.
I think it was more of, like, she was just there with me. Like, she does, don't get me wrong, Ashley does work out, but don't get it twisted. She's not like Wonder Woman or, like, she would get eaten alive by, and correct me if I'm wrong, Jonna, but she would get eaten alive by Laurel or Emily Schramm. Like,
yes.
She's not nearly as physically impressive as either of them.
So where do you guys stand now? You and Ashley, are you friends? Are you frenemies? What's going on? They're friends.
Actually, no, just cordial. Like we like we've been since the show. Like it was really nice like we're not friends. Right? I mean, sometimes she annoys me. Like we had to go to the VMAs and she was there and she was a little bit of a, you know, a nuisance there. But like for the most part, like we just. We don't really have to deal with each other, so it's not like we're friends.
Let's
like we're
talk enemies. About the VMAs.
Well, I mean, how did she take you and Jonna's relationship? Jonna, was she? I remember you said
you
something
know,
like
she was very nice cool. to me. I have nothing bad to say about Ashley. She handled it really well because if I were her in her position, I wouldn't have been able to handle it with as much class as
right.
she did. Like she.
No,
really
you know
nice,
what?
So.
One night I do remember she came up to me and she said. She did say, you know, if anything, I just kind of don't want you to get hurt. And so if anything, Ashley's,
yeah,
you know,
she's
probably both of our, she's actually both of our friends because she actually was just looking out for me. So anything she said or did, I think it was just out of, like, making sure, like, that I was okay more than anything. I think she has really good intentions most of the time. And she, I remember her pulling Jonna aside and they both walked away from that. I don't know what they said to each other, but they both walked away, like, smiling, and I think it was more of just like making sure that it was genuine.
And she let you borrow a dress or something, right?
Oh no.
Well, no, I think that's nice of her. I think that's nice.
What
I know
nice
how,
of her.
I know how it could have came off.
It is
off,
nice of her. She's like, she's not like she's very nice. Like it was a great thing for her to do. Just in that house with so many different.
Zach, she told me that she's never worn that dress before on air, and it's never appeared. And I went back and I actually watched one of your episodes, and it's like when you and Ashley are first falling for each other, it's like that's the dress she's wearing.
That
is a little awkward.
We're gonna give her the benefit of the doubt on that one, maybe.
All right. Well, all right, one more relationship question, then we're gonna get back to this episode. But Zach, since we haven't had you on the show, the rumor has it that. From what I heard, and it's actually you just said something totally different. I heard that Ashley cheated on you, and that's why you broke up with her because she hurt your heart. And now you're saying that she broke up with you, or did you break up with her?
Ashley broke up with me, and at first I had heard she cheated on me. I had heard from multiple people, but because I'm not gonna say she did or she didn't because I wasn't there. I have never. I don't know. She probably. I would have to say that she was probably talking to someone else, but I doubt 100% that she actually physically
did you cheat on her, Zach? I think that's what
her.
They're asking.
Well, yeah, that's the other half of the question. Is I mean, I'm gonna put it out there because that's what we do here at AfterBuzz. But while we were in Vegas at the Vegas Bash, there was a little rumor buzzing around about you and a bad girl, and that bad girl is the one who came between you and
oh,
Ashley.
No.
No, she didn't come between me and Ashley. She don't. I'm going to let Jonna take that one.
Was it after Ashley? I think that's what they're asking.
So
yeah, that was after. That was like, okay, here's what happened with the bad girl. Because I'll be completely honest.
Please
I
do.
I did an appearance with her, and I straight up told her, like, because I was single, and I was, like, in a crazy mentality. Like, I was going out doing an appearance. I told her that I was not at all, like, into her. I was never going to date her. I was never going to be with her. And it was, like, a random, crazy, like, night. And I was like, this means nothing at all. And the next day after the appearances, we, like, it was, like, a three-day thing. I flew home thinking it was over. And that was it. It was, like, a kind of just, like, a...
Oh, she's stage five. So.
I don't know what you would call that. But... then now I guess it's still keeps resurfacing itself. And I seem to be... seems to be a topic of discussion everywhere she goes.
It sure is, from what
she posted pictures of you like 20 hours ago of you guys like making out, so
sexy
from six Wait, months ago.
Can I completely change the subject for one second? I have something that I've
not for one second. Just change the subject. Let's just move on.
Change the subject. I don't know if you're gonna like this one any better, but there's something I've been dying to ask you. What happened? You don't seem to be doing your face regimen anymore with the like 6 hours of the skincare and the green gook and the hair products. Is there just no time for it on Battle of the Seasons?
No editing time for it.
I don't know. I mean, I guess like I finally just had to realize when you got it, you got it. It doesn't matter what kind of shit you put on your face, right?
All right. When you got it, you got it. Now, here are three guys I'm going to put out there that clearly don't got it because they felt like they were out of the alliances.
Who are you about to put on
blast? I was
going to
say ask Zach about Trey.
Trey, Alton, and Chet. They were upset because they kind of felt like, and it makes sense because the other teammates, you know, obviously MTV was really smart about this game. They figured that two people on each team are going to kind of team up together. And then not only is it battle of the seasons, but it's going to be battle within your season.
Right.
And so these three guys were upset. Trey's pissed because he felt like people were aiming for him because, you know, Marie and
Rob
were fully a part of the alliance. I mean, what did you think of these what do we want to call these people? These strays?
Floaters.
These floaters, that's a better word for it. What did you think of that, you know, these floaters? And I mean, what's your opinion on Trey? He seems very hard-headed. You know, we met him in Vegas, seems like a really cool guy, but very, you know, when I think to the left, I'm going to think fully to the left, and there's no changing him. What did you think of Trey?
What did I personally think of Trey?
Yes, and his strategy to the challenge.
I think Trey is a fake, camera-hungry little hobbit.
So you like him a lot.
if I ever ran into him outside of a place where if I hit him, I would lose money, I would annihilate him and ruin his life. Because, to be honest with you, I'm going to be completely honest with you. We wanted, and you can ask anyone there, I personally and my team personally wanted St. Thomas there because they could not beat San Diego or Cancun in anything. There was not one thing that we were all smarter than them. We were all more athletic than them. We were stronger, the whole nine yards. And to be completely honest with you, they may have been able to make it to a final if it weren't for Trey. If they would have just not been such monster douchebags and, like, all he wanted was camera time. I think he knew that if he stepped out against me and Frank and said, "Oh well, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna do this. I'm gonna blow Wes. Pull Wes and Danny. I'm gonna get more camera time." And then he's talking like, "Oh, the money doesn't mean come shut up." Like, 60-some, whatever it is, $250,000 split by four, 60-some thousand. That's life changing, at least for your year. You know, you can at least do some cool stuff with it. You're not going to say no to that. Like, he could have won money if he wasn't such a moron.
Okay, how do we know that Trey didn't win?
Yeah, what happened?
We don't know that, Zach.
That's what it came down to with every other team. For most of the teams there in our alliance, it really wasn't about camera time. It was about winning the money. I was there to win money and make my life better. I wasn't there to, you know, like, disagree with anyone. Like, if you notice, I've had nothing to do these last two episodes because I literally was going with the flow just trying to stay out of the heat until I had to be in it so that I could get closer to the money. And that's the same thing Jonna was doing. She actually wanted to get him out of there because she knew he was just a cancer to the entire game.
Okay, we've had some people on the show who've loved Trey, and we've had some people on the show who've hated Trey, and he seems to be almost as loved/hated as Frank is.
And that's what Devin said. She said the house was kind of split
really
up with 50-50 they liked
50 on him. And what I will say about meeting him personally is that he was nothing but nice to us. Absolutely.
Trey was really nice to me.
Yeah, he was very, very sweet. But from watching him on the show, his strategy sucks.
But do you think I mean, let's come down to it personality-wise, off the show and being on the show. On the show, you have to have a character. You have to have a strategy.
Right.
For this game. I mean, we sat here with Mark Long last week, and, you know, he's done this stuff how many
Since
years?
Since the first Road Rules.
And, you know.
You know, 45 years.
Right. And he kind of had to, he gave us, he was like, you know, at the end of the day, you have to come on here with a strategy, and it's more mental. So would you say Trey had, so you're basically saying Trey didn't have a strategy, period?
Trey's a freaking moron. Are you serious? Do you think I like taking orders from anyone? No, I don't. I literally sat there, observed, listened. Like, I went with the flow, and I'm not someone that goes with the flow, but you hand $250,000 in front of my face, I'm going to go with the flow until I'm, like, in a corner, and then I'm going to, like, lash out. But, like, are you serious? We literally sat down with them. You saw that last episode of the episode before.
Right.
We sat down with them, and we're like, look, chill out. Just, like, do what the alliance says we're going to do. We're all going to be, like, one head. We seriously sat there and we talked to him about it. And we said, like, just
gonna
chill out and this is what's going to happen. And
yeah, that's what I'm saying. How do you know when to go with the flow and how do you know when to step up? I mean, because it seems if you step up too soon, then you have a target. But if you just go with the flow, then you're not appreciated in the game.
That was a good question.
In this situation, Cancun sat down with them and so did San Diego. So this is twice now that someone's been like, we don't know where you're at. We want you guys here because we want them there because they were in a good team. They weren't good. And they were decent at some things, but they weren't good at anything. They were never going to win. We wanted them there because then there was just a vote towards us. And if someone's telling you that straight up, like, just just settle down. You're okay. We're not going to send you in. If you just chill out and start acting like an idiot, you go with the flow.
Okay. Yeah. And he wouldn't. He was just like, well, I'm going to do whatever I want.
All right. So let's talk about the challenge, tonight's challenge. Don't weigh me down.
How are we going to not mention Big Easy and Devin?
Oh, well, we're going to get there. But I'm just, we have like 20 minutes left, so we need to talk about the actual challenge.
Okay.
So our, you know, fans at home. But actually, speaking of the fans, you guys, we love you to death. And we know you guys have been watching us on YouTube. We need your help to get us to number one. You guys did so well with us on The Real World. Now we need you to help on the challenge. Go to the iTunes store, type in AFTERBUZZ TV, The Challenge. Subscribe, rate, comment, and download. And here we go. If you guys leave us a comment with your Twitter handle, and we'll give you guys a shout out on the show. So please.
Can I ask my question on the challenge then?
Go ahead.
I have to ask you, why weren't you and Frank holding the rocks up? Why were you paired with Sam?
It was boy
girl.
Because
it had to be a boy and a girl.
Oh. Yeah. I didn't even realize that when we were watching. I was like, okay, never mind that. I was like, well, I don't understand. All these teams are picking these weak people. Like, what the hell's going on? Went right over my head.
So basically, Trey wants to help Brooklyn. Why?
Why?
Yeah.
Can anyone just answer that question?
I didn't see the first part of it.
Because Brooklyn doesn't have Frank or Zach on their team.
And that's basically what it comes down to.
Because
he wanted to do the opposite of what Frank and Zach wanted to do because he saw Trey's probably an alpha male in his little hobbit, you know, circle of friends. And he probably saw the fact that he probably went into that show that he was going to run it because he's got, you know, pecs. And when he saw that he wasn't going to run it, probably he was butthurt and he wanted to do whatever he could to stand out against Frank and I. I'm telling you, it had everything to do with his ego.
He said he was friends with those people. So maybe it just had to do with friendship?
Like, you know what? He's gonna honestly say he's friends with those people. He knew those people no longer than I did. He's not friends with them. Come on, like.
So you can make enemies way faster than you can make friends. That's what we're learning.
I didn't make enemies. I just like the only person I trusted in there from the whole like was Frank. Cause he's the only person I really knew. Him, Sam, and Ashley.
Wow.
So those are people that I confided in. I didn't confide in people that I've watched on TV and sound like a super fan.
So everyone puts the rocks in Brooklyn's basket, Brooklyn gets eliminated. Then everyone does fresh meat, and, I mean, can we just get a hand clap for
Big Easy? What the hell?
That was some beast mode.
There was no more room for rocks. If he could have just held on, they couldn't put any more rocks in.
No, and what I really would have loved to have seen, especially Zach, because you made the comment, I wish I could have did this alone.
Right.
I would have loved to have seen you and Big Easy in, like, a... lifting those rocks. That would have just been epic for MTV.
Like his legs. Like he got to pull like the ropes back.
Yeah. Right. I feel like it was kind of did more good than harm.
Yeah, it
did. In this case.
And it's funny because when you're watching the interviews with Big Easy, his arms look skinny. Like he used to be big.
Oh my gosh. I can't listen to this. I seriously can't even listen to this.
Why not? What are we saying that is upsetting the god, Zach?
I'm telling you right now that thing was easier to hold up if you had, because you could stand there. He was resting it. All the weight was resting on his thighs. He was using nothing with his arms. Because you're going to tell me that this kid's strong? He couldn't climb up a rope ladder that Lacey got up the first try. That Preston climbed up twice. So you're going to sit here and tell me that Big Easy's strong, this and that. It was clearly an advantage man on a one-person team. Like, I'm so sick of everyone stroking this kid's ego because he went from awful to mediocre. Since when do we celebrate mediocrity on a challenge? Don't tell me that. Like, he's obese.
He needs
okay,
his own
yeah, you used to be obese, and now you're fat. You still can't climb up a ladder that freaking, like, Jasmine, Devin, Preston, Lacey, they all got up that ladder.
Well, he's got a lot more weight to carry.
Yeah, the whole time.
Come on.
Like, let's stroke his ego a little more.
All right. Well, let's get past that.
When you come back from Michigan, we are dragging you into studio. Tell it like it is.
No, seriously, like, I watch Big Easy on TV, and all I do is smell fried chicken through my TV screen. It's disgusting. Like, he's a filthy human being. And I'm going to tell you this I've done an appearance with him, and he tried to get in my face, and I beat his ass in the middle of 4th Street in Kentucky.
You beat his ass?
Zach.
Yeah, I threw him on the ground and was sucker punching him.
Why?
In the middle of 4th Street in Kentucky.
How did this happen?
Because Big Easy got on his face.
But I'm just saying, why were you guys in Kentucky?
That Zach was doing
because,
in Kentucky, I think.
Because we were doing an appearance. It was me. This is a rogue appearance. It was me, Kitty Doyle, Cyrus, and Big Easy. We were doing an appearance, and Big Easy was, like, calling Katie every name under the book. He's like, you hole, you slut, you this. And I was just like, dude, stop. And then he got in my face, and I was like beating him up in the middle of Kentucky. Like, I'm so sick. Like, and him and Devin, like, are you serious? Like, this is a couple that we're actually going to spend time, like, oh my gosh.
Well, okay, let's talk about that, actually. Him and Devin, which, Devin, girl. She's definitely calling in. I'm going to have her call in next week because we need her to explain this whole situation.
It's a Devin and Easy situation.
They're like apparently dating, which we're not going to call it. She said it was dating on the show.
Right.
She used the term dating. Now, Zach, are you outside like blocking your car or something? I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
I'm going to call the showmance, not a real date. Cause,
there were a few.
This was... If you can carry it outside of the show, then I believe it's real. But when it's just a couple episodes. But my issue is this. Eric arguing about the age difference.
Oh. I don't even understand what the hell that was. She never even said how old her oldest boyfriend was. Who gives a fuck?
What does that have to do with the challenge?
That pissed me off
but,
so much.
Even the relationship. In a relationship. But I mean.
Who cares?
How long did they first, were they talking? Like, when did they first start? Like, was it serious?
A couple weeks. Most.
So, like, some of you guys didn't even realize
it
or know?
How long before this elimination round were Devin and Easy together?
I was just saying, at this point, I didn't even know Devin's name, like, in the show.
Oh, my God.
Like, I didn't even know.
Like, it was pretty.
It was terrible. It's like, I mean, I don't even know how she did it. Like, seriously, like, you could, like, he is a living slip and slide. Like, there's more bacon grease coming out of his pores.
I cannot with you.
So what was
ranch dressing cologne does not exist anywhere but Big Easy's closet.
If you had to say something nice, what would you say attracted Devin to Big Easy? Is he funny? Is he give me something nice so people don't write on our wall and write on YouTube being like, we hate Zach. Never have him call.
No, I'm gonna stick up. I'm gonna say this about him, Zach. I met him in Vegas.
That's
and
nice.
He was just, well, I'm not even gonna say that. He was just. A term that I use is called mayo. He's mayo. Mayo's very bland and just, you know, you kind of didn't get
there.
The spot. Yeah, he was.
Okay, but here's my thing, dude. You meet people in Vegas, right? Like, they have no reason not to be nice to you because you're putting them on the internet. Like, get into a show where you're competing for a large sum of money and people's true colors start to come out. And then tell me that this guy's a cool dude, that he's chill, that he's this, he's that. Like, it's. Like, you're getting a skewed version of, like, everyone. Because, of course, everyone's going to be nice to you because you're putting them on blast on national TV or the internet, you know? Like, I don't know. Like,
but, I mean, also, a lot of the people, Zach, they say, you know, on the challenge, you know, yeah, they have beef. But then off the challenge, or maybe it's because they've been doing this for so many years that it's just like, okay, I know what's going to happen when we go on the show. There's going to be, I mean, look at you, Jenna. You went on the show. You and Jasmine originally didn't, like, get along.
Yeah.
You know, now it seems like you guys,
get along when we have to. I mean, I love Jasmine to death outside of this, but.
Is it just like you learn, like, okay, this is the show. I need to get along with her.
Yeah.
We're cordial.
It's about money. You're in a competition. You're in a game show.
But it's not like you're calling her to, like, hey, girl, let's go watch movies or.
No.
Right. You know, you understand.
Love the girl, but no.
Right. You understand where it comes and goes. Well, all right, Zach. I mean, what are we missing? What are we missing?
What big question.
Yeah,
I want to know who you're friends with then on the show still that you would call, that you do talk to.
I actually don't want to know who your friends are. I want to know who you dislike from this season.
How about both?
Don't ask him. Please don't ask him.
Well, I feel.
Oh, yeah, he's going to get it.
Who do you?
I said, don't ask Zach who he doesn't like.
No, I think he would love to. I feel like he's the type of guy that would love to tell us. Zach, who did you dislike from this season and why? Other than Trey, because we had like a 20-minute
And Easy.
And Easy.
Okay, well, yeah, you're right. I didn't like Trey because of the, like, terrible little man syndrome that oozes from him. I really wasn't a fan of Big Easy on the show, obviously. I could not stand Alton.
You know what?
I think.
Yeah.
I could not stand Alton. I think Alton might be a terrorist.
You know what I said, guys? I don't know if you guys have ever seen RuPaul's Drag Race, but have you ever seen RuPaul when she's not in drag? Kind of looks like Alton. Just putting that out there.
Oh,
go ahead.
I've seen RuPaul's Alton sitting in his room crying right now.
Keep going, Zach.
No, Alton's surfing bigger waves every day, apparently. You know. I didn't like Dustin and Chad at first, but they grew on me, and I actually, like them now. Like, I think Dustin's actually, even though, like, it's really creepy the way he's always talking in, like, his soft porn voice to people. Like, that really creeps me out. But, like, he's actually not bad to watch, and he's a pretty, like, he's a nice guy. Chet, I didn't get along at first, but I think now Chet's very, he's, like, actually a really cool guy.
Now, you get, we're going to see a fight from of you, Frank, and Dustin, right? Bringing up the frat pad situation.
Yeah.
Like, don't
come on. I mean, like, if he says anything to you, like, all you have to, like, you keep, like, Dustin will lose every argument for the rest of his career.
Yes, he will.
On these shows because all you have to do is bring up his past, and it's like, oh, God, I got to shut up now because I used to, you know.
So how come you're okay?
Or just call him Spencer.
So how come you're okay with him now, but Frank still hates his frickin' guts? Like, Frank will go off on him the way that you go off on Big Easy.
Dustin never had a problem with me. It was more of me and Alton and Frank and Dustin. But the fact that Frank and I were so close, that just kind of made me, like, hate him too when I was in the situation. But I really didn't have much of a problem with Dustin. But Dustin got into it with Frank a lot. But the other thing is, like, Dustin also was very creepy with Frank and, like, very, like, sexually, like, he would always be touching him and stuff. So that was weird.
Because you and Jesse are best friends.
But I have to say, every other episode I absolutely shout on Dustin, but tonight he was so cute, and the way he was calming down Nany, and
but that was like, because Nani's his fag hag.
Fair enough. Okay.
All right, but so obviously, you know, let's also get this in. From what we see, you're still talking to Janae. You guys still got the love romance going on?
Yeah, she calls me every now and then.
Keeping it cash. All right.
She is definitely keeping it casual.
Oh my God. So casual.
So, all right. Really
I'm not getting the jokes right now. It's going right over my head.
You're clearly being sarcastic. Zach, you have to say that we're dating.
Yeah, we're dating.
Aww. But it's not a showmance, guys, because the show's over.
Yeah, it's over.
All right, but before we get into predictions, really quickly, I'm really excited that you guys follow us here at AfterBuzz. We have so many more new shows coming up. The fall season's coming up. I'm not going to be out of the house because I'm obsessed with fall TV.
Oh, my God, except when you're in here.
Jersey Shore, Vampire Diaries.
Gossip Girl.
The New Girl's already back.
Homeland.
Fox Tuesdays. It's all here. AfterBuzz is covering it all. So make sure you tune into all your favorite TV shows. And then come on to AfterBuzz afterwards, and we'll be talking all the ish about them. Now, next week, what do we think's going on? We got Brooklyn versus Fresh Meat.
Devin, Big Easy.
And now,
what do you predict is that going to happen?
Does that not sound like a Super Bowl? Like, it sounds like you're going to go watch a girls' soccer game. Devin versus Big Easy in the arena. Let's go watch ninth grade girls' soccer instead. Or let's watch paint dry.
Well, here's my thing. The argument with Camilla earlier, and I'm just like, girl, shut up.
Oh my God.
She always gets mad when she knows she's wrong or, you know.
Camilla?
Yeah.
I want to squeeze that girl until her guts come out.
Camilla is not the most ridiculous human being you've ever seen. Like, she somehow manipulates every situation with Carl Maria not wanting to go into the arena with Carl Maria not being a team player because she doesn't want to go home, but Camilla being such a great team player,
right.
I don't get it. Like,
I want to punch her in the tits. She's so annoying. That girl is so freaking annoying.
What did you think of her last episode? What did you think of her?
Camilla?
Yeah. Because nobody that's come on the show has liked her.
You don't have a bad thing to say about anybody. This girl, like,
because she knows how to play the game.
She's like, no, nice. I'm just really bad at talking bad about people, but I don't know. Camilla and I had our thing on Rivals, and we didn't really like each other. But on this show, I kind of understood her. Well, yeah, we avoided each other, but I kind of understood her a little bit because she came into a house where, like, no one, like, everyone had already formed friendships, and she wasn't a part of everything. And so I kind of knew how it felt to be the odd man out. Like, she's been on many challenges, but, like, it's almost like she's a rookie in this challenge. Because
the girl
no
can't
one
drink for shit. That's so, all I care about.
Roxy,
stop drinking. You're so annoying.
Oh my God, every time
going home next week, do we think it's going to be Brooklyn or Fresh Meat?
Fresh Meat. No,
I'm
actually, I don't know.
I'm going to say Fresh Meat.
It might be Brooklyn.
I'm hoping Fresh Meat.
One of the two.
Let's just get them out completely.
My money's on one of the two of them are going home.
All right, guys. I want to thank you guys so much. Zach, John. I'm so sorry.
Janae.
It's okay.
No, I just had five things in my head. Thank you guys so much for joining us here tonight. Thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you hit us up on AfterBuzz TV, on Facebook, Twitter. We're on Instagram now. Yeah. You guys can follow me on Twitter at DJ Jesse J.
At Roxy Striar.
At Jonna Mannion.
Zach, where can they follow you at?
Zach MTV.
You can follow me at Zach MTV.
All right, guys. Until next week, same time, same place. Peace.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principal.